today's adventure begins in a different car, actually a loaner. Call it a sports car. My car is once again in the shop getting a little work done to it, so a little different for this video. And getting some caffeine, was up pretty late last night, running around with the car, and yeah, kind of got a little bit of killer instinct assembled. We'll get to the little bit of that later on in the video, but yeah, definitely need a coffee. Welcome to a midweek walk and talk, October 1st. Fall has been here for a couple of days. Weather is changing. I am sporting a t-shirt. Might be the last time we'll be in short sleeves. Might be a long sleeve for the remainder of the year heading into 2025. About this time last year, some new stuff was showing up at some of the retailers like Kohl's. It's happening again. We'll get into that. Also, something big coming to Best Buy. And this one might really surprise you. It sure caught me off guard this morning. And I kind of took a step back going, wow, did I luck out? And did I luck out that my buddy was able to loan me his car, because when I got home yesterday, there was some smoke coming from one of the tires. Something wasn't working right. And I immediately texted my friend and he said, when it cools down, bring the car over. I'll give you mine and we'll take a look at it. So, you know, if it's not one thing, it's something else. Hopefully, he'll be able to, you know, get the car back. We have a lot of walk and talks to do. And, you know, I'm trying to get another year out of the car. Fingers crossed. But, you know, eventually, you know, the older your car gets, you know, things break down and, you know, I'm trying to make it through the winter. See, the Christmas, 50% off. Yeah, we're gonna stop at Hobby Lobby really quick. And in being fall, I just wanted to kind of stop here and just take it in. We're in October and there is fall decor everywhere. And actually, I'm gonna go inside because it feels like it's like 98 degrees in this lobby at Hobby Lobby. And some Hobby Lobbies will have the Frogger and some won't. I am keeping my eye. There will be, you know, a couple of Froggers here and there in this whole retro gaming area. You never know when the next kind of bonus giveaway will happen. Whenever we spot kind of that retro gaming stuff, I think that's what I'm gonna, what's this one? Upon further review, I'm going to need more snacks. But like I was saying, I think this is a new Spider-Man picture. $21.99 home decor. So it's good to see when you see the home decor, because when they do have, you know, the 50, 60% off every other week, every 3 weeks, maybe once a month, something like this will be on sale. And yeah, it's pretty good layout of Spider-Man. I'm not gonna really focus on the DC stuff when I'm here this time. We'll just kinda tune in on Spider-Man. I think we've had a pretty solid run with you know who. Remember back in the day when QVC actually sold arcade one-ups? Well, guess what they do? They were big on partycades. This year, they're big on countercades. They have the Ms. Pac-Man countercade priced at $160. Now, we knew that countercades were coming. It is cheaper than a couple other retailers. And I think there's going to be more options, especially at QVC. But the first countercade rehash showing up is Ms. Pac-Man. You go over to Best Buy, it's $179.99. Same price with Target, so it is cheaper at QVC. The only thing is if you can hold off long enough. Last year, and I don't know if we can still count this as if it happened last year, it could happen this year, but in stores at Target was actually 50% off, and there were people actually getting the Ms. Pac-Man for around $76. Only downside, that was in store. When it's online, I'm not sure how that's gonna work. So that might be the best we see. So Kohl's carrying the countercade also at $179.99. Yeah, again, these aren't new products, they're rehashed. But the positive thing to take from whatever countercade we see from Arcade 1-Up, they still have the license. So you see Turtles, you see Mortal Kombat, you see Pac-Man, Ms. Pac-Man, NBA Jam, they still have it. So there's
know, there's things you can get upset about, but there's also things not to worry about.
Vader says, "Fear not. There'll be plenty of products coming." I don't really sound like him at all, do I? "There'll be plenty of products coming from Arcade 1-Up."
I feel like I'm in a race car. Mikey, I won't show too much of your car, I promise. I really appreciate you loaning me your car. I just feel like I'm in a race car. It's so fast off the side. I'm not used to a sports car. And I'd kind of drive a mid-size SUV, call it a crossover. We're at Best Buy. Did notice something this morning. Big. Showing up on the Best Buy website, and I have a prediction that I've kind of stated in the past. I think it's going to show up here.
I will say that I wasn't too excited about this when I first caught wind. First of all, I didn't think it was real. It's indeed real. It's indeed happening. And I think it's going to be a display. I think it's going to be inside Best Buy, and it's going to be similar to what we see at Costco, where they put something out on the floor and people just kind of flock to it with the XLs, with the pub table, you know, then other companies throwing pinball machines. There's a whole different variety going on at Costco right now. Look at what's happening here. Like, there's a total revamp happening at the Home Best Buy. I actually, for a second, didn't think that these were here right now. I think there's a whole new display coming based on what I saw this morning that's showing up unavailable right now at Best Buy, but the fact that it's on their website kind of hinted that be prepared if this is the display model. And I am 100% convinced that we'll be seeing this in a matter of the next coming weeks. You've seen the news. And if you go on Arcade 1-Up, I mean, there's videos all over surfacing this claw machine, and it's a total Arcade 1-Up. If you just saw that control panel, I think it's cool, you know, just to, you know, for the idea. It's not something that I am interested in, that I'm gonna bring home, but I like the idea. I like the fact that they're targeting other people than just, you know, the retro gamers. But right there, that control, I'm not gonna knock this. Again, I like the idea, but it's not something for me. But I really think this is gonna be showing up on the floor.
That was a real-time reaction. I did not see the video prior to just then. And that was kind of my reaction that, I mean, I like the idea. I like the fact that you can come up to these. I don't know. It seems a little Mickey Mousey to me, but I guess that's what to expect. And some new, look at this. So right here was where Mortal Kombat and Pac-Man were. Mortal Kombat, I don't know if Pac-Man was ever over here. And then the kiosk was right here. So they have another racing wheel. Turtle Beach, Raise Your Rank, and then the True Force. But yeah, this is, look at the Xbox controller here. That is pretty pretty sweet. Like what's happening at Best Buy. I'm just preparing myself that there's going to be an Arcade 1-Up claw machine right in this area. Mortal Kombat 2 has sold. Look at this. We have NBA Jam, Big Buck Hunter. MK2 was right here. Somebody came and bought that display model. We'll see if these stick around. You can see the power pack down there, the plug. I'm not sure what to call that, the power brick. We'll see if these stick around. And if there's a claw machine kinda in the vicinity, but I don't, yeah, all these kind of like workstation types. You can see the power coming down here. We saw some of these set up about a week ago. We were here and I kinda thought for a second that we'd see the claw machine here. Even though it's showing up unavailable at Best Buy, look at everything happening here. They're completely changing up everything. We saw a lot of TVs at the last two Best Buys we were at. They are gearing up for the holidays. It's crazy. Okay, so when I went online this morning, before I left for work, I took a screenshot at 4:51 in the morning
And I wasn't sure if this would show up. If you know, sometimes you see this show up at Best Buy, then they take it down. But the first images, before I saw the video, of the arcade went a claw machine for $4.99. And if these were on other videos, I apologize. I have been kind of out of the loop for a couple of days. It's been crazy getting stuff done around the house, of course doing videos, and then having the car issue. Plus I'm building Killer Instinct Pro at the moment, and I'll get to that near the end of the video. But just a couple different images of the claw machine, and I just want to point out it's a pretty bland look. You got the arcade one up. I wonder when you turn it on if it makes that arcade one up, like that sound when it starts up. But what I do like about this is the size. 66 inches tall. So at least it's big, and it's not something like NBA Jam where it's about 57, 58, 59 inches. I mean, 66, it's gonna come up to, you know, about right here. So at least we have that going for us. And I know there's a lot of excitement, and I'm not knocking it. I wanted to kind of give my reaction on this and the fact that I think this is their next display unit. Now, something was brought to my attention earlier today. It's from my buddy Skids. Sent me a message, and he says, "You lucked out. You bought Killer Instinct Pro at the right time." And I'm like, oh my gosh, did the price go up? Because they were offering free shipping and no taxes. So the base price of $999.99 is what I paid, nothing more, nothing less. And I looked at this message from him, and I was shocked. On the Arcade 1UP website, we just watched kind of the advertisement track mode preview of the claw machine, and right on the top is KI Pro. And you can see right here, it is sold out. And when I saw a screenshot that Skids took and he sent me, I couldn't believe it. I said, you know, if I wouldn't have ordered when I did, which was about 9 days ago, I wouldn't have got KI Pro. I would have been just kicking myself in the tail for this. Something that I've been, you know, watching. And yeah, we all want stuff to come down. You know, it's like if it was ever $6.99, of course I'd pick it up. But when I saw the fact that shipping was now included, and they wiped out the sales tax, they wanted to move these. And I'm sure they thought, let's see if people budge on $9.99, and they did. Maybe somebody bought them up and they're gonna resell them. I'll show you. There's things in the review, and I'm working on the build on the review right now, but I'll show you a couple of things when I get home on KI that I just don't want to drag out the review. I don't want to have it, you know, 35 minutes, but I'll show you a couple of things, and there might be a surprise when I show you what number KI Pro I have. And there is something else about KI, and it kind of alters what I think about other things like the claw machine and possibly other, you know, cabinets we could get from Arcade 1UP. Man, this is the screenshot that Skid sent me earlier today, and when I saw that, I mean, I looked right at my buddy Steve at work, and I said, oh my gosh, KI Pro is sold out. He goes, what's KI Pro? And I go, never mind. That was a good one. I had to say it. No, if I were to say Killer Instinct, he would have known what I was talking about. But Shaq, the one thing I want to say, because I've pretty much built KI Pro, it's almost assembled. I had a late night last night because I had car situation. I wasn't able to complete. I didn't want to stay up too late. You know, I mean, I get up so early. The one thing I want to say about Shaq Jam is I wish it would have been everything that KI Pro is. And that's kind of what I've been thinking about today. You know, we see the claw machine. I'm going to show you a couple of things about KI Pro from my perspective. And I don't know if it's going to show up in the review. There's a little bit of an unboxing, but the actual review, like, I don't know if you'll be able to see it the way I did, the way I do. And it's just, I wish we got that, you know, going forward. Like, I mean, not going back to this version of NBA Jam, but you know, in 2023, 2024, like, they gave us this and we didn't see anything else. And then they go a different direction and then they bring other products. This is, I don't even know how to describe KI Pro. I'll point out a couple of things, but it kind of alters what we're gonna get knowing what we really got from KI Pro.
And David Deming did warn me on that. He has KI Pro and he left me a message, comment, and he said it's gonna change the way you think about Arcade 1UP, and it kind of does. And I haven't even finished the build yet. When I started taking the boxes out, when I started opening them up, I caught a couple of clips because I didn't want to make it too long of the unboxing, just to kind of give everybody kind of, you know, this is what to expect. Like, here's how it looked taking it out and seeing some of this stuff. I was blown away, and I can't believe that we're not going to get anything like this from them again. I understand that they sat around for almost 3 years, and I don't know if shipping was free. I don't know what happened. Was it 2022 or late, you know, early 2023? Whenever these became available for the first time, I don't know if shipping was included, but they moved them out at $999.99. Like, I bought it. I bought in. I was going to get an ALP. I ended up buying KI Pro. And, you know, people are like, you know, if it drops, so you should have just waited. And I just felt that this was as good of a deal as I'm going to get. And that's why I decided to buy. And if I would have waited, I wouldn't have got it at all. I probably wouldn't even have bought the ALP when the NOD ended last night. And I'd be sitting here going, okay, I missed out on KI. I missed out on NOD sale. Yes, they're going to be at the Pinball Expo, and, you know, I could get it there, but I'm just kind of throwing it out there that, you know, if you wait on something and then you miss out on something else, and then you're kind of in this spot where, well, now what? And I didn't want to be in that spot. I've waited a long time to pick up an Arcade 1UP, and I'm glad I got it. I just want to say that I'm happy I bought KI Pro. I know I spent $1,000. It's crazy. Is it worth it? I haven't, you know, I don't know yet, but there's nothing else like it.
So mine is 421 of 500. So when I saw that it sold out, are these in order? I mean, are they in the warehouse? Did they line these up? Did 79 of these sell after I ordered mine? Or, I mean, did 10 people order the same day I did? Did others see the fact that it's a little cheaper? I mean, it's not a sale, but, you know, they shaved off the shipping, they shaved off the sales tax. Was it enough for people to buy? Mine's 421. Somebody's got 500. Somebody has one of 500. So it's a surprise that they're sold out. I did want to show one of the boxes that came out of the main Killer Instinct box. This is the stool. Everything besides this box right here, which is actually this part on this stool, and the back right here, this bracket, everything else is inside of this box. Reminds me a lot of Dragon's Lair. Dragon's Lair had the all black. KI Pro has the all blue. And it does have that stool logo right here. And I didn't want to just rush into putting together the stool, kind of saving that for the end, but just to kind of give you a little spoiler on, you know, what to expect when you open up KI. It's the same box as any other Arcade 1UP. It's just the inside all has that blue theming. I pre-ordered the Evercade Alpha about a month, maybe a little longer. All of us who bought in on that should have ours delivered. I went through Amazon. Offhand, I want to say I spent maybe $224, maybe it was a little bit more. I can't remember. It was probably July or August when I placed that order. There was two styles. There was the big blue, more of a fighter, heavy countercade, and then the Mega Man, which had more beat-em-ups. That's the one I went with, but you could swap out the marquees. So the big selling point was, you know, I could put in Final Fight. I could play Knights of the Round on a countercade. Maybe in time, getting rid of something like
Big Blue, because I have it on here, open up a spot, you never know. There was all this deciding factor of why I went with what I did. Maybe the fact that they're bringing back the countercades this time is not only the holidays, but to give Evercade a little competition. They obviously still have the license. There's NBA Jam, there's Pac-Man, Ms. Pac-Man, Turtles. There might be something else I just can't think of. They can still sell those countercades. Only downside, they might be the one player and the marquees might not light up, but just kind of thinking about that when I was driving home. And maybe they think that something like a Turtles countercade would sell better than a three-quarter. It's the only thing I can think of why they wouldn't just give us, I mean, if they can still produce Turtles, if they could still do it, why they wouldn't give us a deluxe, dare I say an XL, is they just probably don't think it's worth the risk. They figure so many people have this Turtles, the countercade is cheaper to make. I don't know. I'm just throwing some ideas around on their thought process, why countercades and not full size. The fact of the matter is, we're still getting countercades from Arcade 1UP, along with the claw machine that may or may not, you know, really, you know, kind of strike you as something you want. I don't want it. I like the idea. I think their strategy is going to work because of Costco. Okay, now this is going to seem a little tight. I get it. The review is going to be tough. I put together both the bottom and the top part last night. Just have a couple of things to put in there. I don't want to show off too much. But what I do want to mention is everything you're looking at here is thicker than any other cabinets you have or have put together. I'm going to save the control deck. I have heard people not happy about the controls. From what I've experienced, even though I haven't played it, just going up there. This is close. I want to save this for you. I was impressed. I was blown away. Only thing that resembled, you know, the build is this panel right here where the coin doors are. And that's just not any coin door. I'll finish putting this together tonight. Here's the backs. Not black, unfortunately. It's just your same old, you know, generic looking backing. You can see it behind Time Crisis. And I didn't know that we had screw cap covers. I couldn't confirm that. They do. They in fact do for this price. I'm glad that they included that. After putting in this far and then seeing, you know, the claw machine, I that's why I wasn't too blown away. Because I wish that every Arcade 1UP going forward was like this. And that's kind of why I didn't have a super reaction when I saw it. A review coming soon. I'm going to finish this tonight. Even this panel, if you have KI, I actually got a new decal when I had my 3/4. I mean, just look at how thick this is. Everything is a step up. I don't know if it's worth the price, but you know, unless the system's wrong, these are completely sold out now. And that's going to do it for today. I got a lot of work to do. I'm going to finish the build and then tomorrow probably do the review on KI, and should be the video to follow providing some big news or a huge national day. But I'm excited to really showcase that cabinet. There's things about it, and I'm just staring at these joysticks right now, and I just want to say that I've heard people that were not happy with the joysticks on KI Pro, and they took them out. From what I've experienced, I don't know, maybe it plays bad. It's unbelievable. It's not this. It is not this at all. Not even close. I'll see you guys tomorrow.